Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and on the behalf of students, staff, and administration of Royal Bay Secondary School, we would like to welcome you to the 2020 graduation ceremony. I am Kevin Royal.
And I'm Bryn Smith.
And we will be your hosts.
It has been a long journey which has brought us to this moment. As parents, grandparents, brothers or sisters, other family or friends, you've shared in the development, learning, and the growth of these young adults. You've been the help and support of these students who will be recognized here today.
So now, I would like to ask that we pay recognition to the graduating class of 2020.
Royal Bay is proud of its many talented graduates. Today, I hope you will enjoy hearing from some of them. At this time, we would like to introduce Kyra Mitchell-Kennedy, Shannon Daig, and Bethany Tran to sing O Canada.
O Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love.
At this time, I would like to call upon Sitaluk, our elder in residence, Brother Rick Peter from Kukutsun in Sayanu.
Ah, Siamna Siaya, Siamna Slaini in this white cut, Heights can sap, TM, Heights can sap, Nia Slashin sap, TM. Our brothers and sisters, welcoming each and every one of you here to this ceremony. As basically what I said in our language. This year is a very difficult year for all of us, students, teachers, adults, mentors, brothers and elders and residents, because Mother Nature, Chayels, our Creator, has given us another item to deal with to see just exactly how strong we are as individuals and being supportive with each other and for each other. And those of you graduating this year, it's been a long, hard road. This year is an even harder road. And I know that you are all looking forward to in person, and this is as close as we can all get together for right now. But as you all know, you can always get a hold of me 247 anywhere and everywhere. That's how I was taught, and that's how I believe. So to all of you, my graduating little brothers and sisters, I hope that whatever avenue that you guys are doing in your futures, your decisions for your abilities to achieve, that you have the best of the best to help you get through all of those. Haitsapka. Before I pass you on to our other brothers and sisters here, just want to sing you guys all a song, not only for you, but for everybody else that's here with us in spirit and in person. And this is for everybody. Say, Heights up, get them. Heights go. Clicko, clicko. Kila gasla. Sheshe, doze. Arigato. Merci beaucoup. Dungavel. Thank you.
Heishka.
Thank you, Brother Rick Peter, for taking the time to join us here today. And now, the time has come to meet the members of the graduating class of 2020.
Here to introduce the graduation class of 2020 is Mr. Rowan Bizo, Mr. John Froese, Ms. Daniel Huckaluck, and Mr. Glenn Whitney.
Mohammed Abdelghani.
Mohammed is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Community Service, as well as the recipient of the Dunspear PAC Bursary. Mo has accomplished the best role in Spanish 12, Binabuela, which means grandma in English. Mo is looking forward to attending UVic and completing a degree in biology. He would like to thank all his teachers for helping him throughout his years, but most of all, Mo wants to thank his mama and grandpa for raising him up into the person he is today.
Liam Adair.
As a student at Royal Bay, Liam has gained a passion for performance. He has enjoyed being in both Pace Musical Theatre Academy and the Royal Bay Theatre Productions for the past 2 years. His hope for a future career is as an RCMP officer. Liam would like to make a special shout out to Greg Moyes for helping him get through his homeschooling days. Without him, there would have been a lot of poorly written essays.
Austin Adrian.
Austin's goals are to be bigger than Arnold Schwarzenegger, own an Audi R8, and to make more money than Bill Gates.
Jacob Afonso.
Jacob would like to thank his parents, Dave and Michelle, for always supporting and guiding him.
Elise Anderson Cholette.
Elise's favorite classes were English, law, and history. She worked hard during her high school years. Elise is looking forward to completing the criminal justice program at Camosun College and working towards getting a degree.
Cole Arthur.
Cole was a proud member of the Royal Bay Lacrosse Academy. He has so many great memories during his 4 years here. His best memories are the road trips with the boys. Cole wants to thank Lucas McNeil. He is looking forward to what the future holds for him.
Matthew Atkinson.
Matt is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Physical Activity. He was a member of the senior boys' basketball and volleyball teams and lacrosse academy. Matt consistently demonstrates leadership and has a unique ability to inspire others to work towards their potential. He would like to thank all of his coaches, teachers, teammates, and friends for an amazing 4 years. He would also like to thank his parents and grandparents for their support and always being his number one fan.
Maya Baines.
Maya was a member of the senior girls' basketball team. She's looking forward to continuing her studies in social science at the University of Victoria in the fall. Maya would like to thank her family and friends, and to the class of 2020, hats off to all graduates. Let's celebrate.
Patrice Ballard.
Patrice is planning on going to post-secondary in the fall. Her career path is to first become a nurse and then continue her schooling to be a midwife.
Megan Banner.
Megan has been accepted at both Western and Carleton Universities, but will defer her acceptance until the fall of 2021 to Carleton University due to the uncertainty of current world events. She would like to thank all her teachers for their guidance and support, and her friends for helping make some great memories during her years at Royal Bay.
Maria Jose Benitez Perez.
Maria was an international student at Royal Bay. She will continue her studies in Victoria with the objective of becoming a businesswoman.
Brandon Bondi.
Brandon would like to wish all the grads of 2020 the best of luck.
Natasha Bissett.
Natasha graduated early and plans on attending university in 2021 after her gap year. She will be pursuing a career in interior decorating. She would like to thank her friends and family for supporting her along the way.
Joel Blacklaws.
Joel is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for International Languages. He enjoyed the psychology program at Royal Bay and plans to figure out what is really going on with the human brain at UVic this fall.
Joshua Blanchard.
Josh only had 1 year at Royal Bay. Okay, 6 months. Thanks, COVID. But what a time to remember. As a member of the league champion senior boys soccer team, Josh and his teammates shared many great moments on and off the field, and they are looking forward to sharing many more. Josh would like to thank all of his coaches, but especially Dan the Man. He wants to remind him that no matter the outcome of the game, keep your eyes on the road.
Sarah Borgholm.
Sarah has maintained an honor roll average throughout her years at Royal Bay. She intends to further her education and major in biochemistry at the University of Victoria. Sarah would like to thank Mrs. McKinnon and Mr. Baldwin for being her biggest supporters and motivators.
Natasha Boss.
Natasha is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts. She will be spending her summer in the mythical real world that follows high school. Of course, come September, the joy will fade from her eyes, replaced by the abject horror that follows. Please, tune in next fall as her adventures, eye bags, and stress levels deepen.
Samantha Bourne.
Samantha would like to thank her brother for getting her through high school, as well as her friends, family, and Leanne Harrington for supporting her throughout the years. Shout out to the dance fam.
Emily Brown.
Emily would like to thank Ms. Huckaluck for helping her through her years of school. Next year, she will be attending Camosun College and will be enrolled in the dental hygiene program.
Lorenzo Francesco Bruno Bossi.
Lorenzo would like to acknowledge the support he received throughout his years at high school from his parents and his teachers. He is especially thankful for the inspiration from his grade 11 and 12 marketing and accounting teachers, and he is pursuing a degree in business administration and accounting at Camosun College.
Tiana Baruma.
Tiana plans to attend Camosun College and study business in the fall of 2020. She also hopes to travel as much as possible from now until finishing her degree.
Brock Campbell.
Brock was a member of the Senior Lacrosse Academy and played soccer for Royal Bay. His fondest memory is playing in the Colonist Cup Final.
Donovan Kaplan.
Donovan would like to thank everyone for an awesome year he had with all his great friends and teachers.
Michaela Carlton.
Michaela is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for International Languages. Michaela would like to thank her family and friends for getting her to where she is now. She will miss Spanish with Senora Haddon the most. Next year, Michaela is pursuing an English degree at the University of Victoria.
Lucas Chambers Reynolds.
Lucas would like to thank all the teachers at Royal Bay for making his final year at the school great, as well as their efforts to keep the learning going through quarantine measures to combat COVID-19. He plans to take a year off work and wait for a cure or vaccine before attending post-secondary to pursue a career in teaching.
Ruby D. Charles.
Ruby D. is the recipient of the Frank Gower Memorial Bursary, as well as the recipient of the District Authority Scholarship for Indigenous Languages and Culture. She would like to thank her family and friends for their love and support over the school years. Ruby D. would also like to thank her teachers, Lindsay Lockhart and Jill Lemon.
Ethan Christie.
Ethan was a member of the senior boys volleyball team. He also enjoyed helping coach the Dunsmuir boys volleyball team. He plans to attend Camosun College in the fall and take business administration. Ethan would like to thank his mom, sisters, and especially his dog Quavo for always being there for him.
Garrett Clayton.
Garrett was a member of the senior acting course for 3 of his 4 years at Royal Bay and is excited to apply those skills in the acting program at UVic in the fall. He would also like to thank his group of lunch friends for 4 years of unforgettable memories.
Ashley Clucci.
The rest of our lives start now.
Avery Cobby.
Avery was one of the founding members of the Girls Lacrosse Academy. She has received a scholarship to the University of Victoria and will be studying biology in the fall. Avery would like to thank her family and friends for their support throughout the years.
Owen Cole.
Owen will attend UVic to attain his Bachelor of History degree, minoring in English. He will continue studying Japanese and upon achieving his degree, will move to Japan to teach English there.
Riley Cope.
Riley would like to wish all the grads of 2020 the best of luck.
Paige Cruzo.
Paige would like to thank her family and friends for all their support throughout the years. She will continue her education at Camosun College and is excited for what the future brings.
Gabriel Cunha da Silva.
Gabriel wants to pursue medicine and serve both Canada and Brazil as a great doctor. He wants to save lives and honor his duty. Eventually, he wants to have a political career and fight for his nation's values.
Shannon Dagg.
Shannon was a member of the Dance Academy and the music program throughout all four of her years of high school. She is very excited to get her Bachelor of Arts degree in dance at the University of Calgary.
Emily Daedal.
Emily is the recipient of the Savory Elementary PAC Bursary, as well as one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Physical Activity, and one of the recipients of the Rotary Club of West Shore Scholarship. Emily was a member of the senior girls basketball team and is very proud of their accomplishments. She would like to recognize Mr. Booth and Mrs. Pushka for being truly memorable and amazing teachers. Emily is looking forward to studying financial mathematics at university in the fall.
Trixie Davies.
Trixie is very thankful for her time at Royal Bay. A special thanks to her dad for making her breakfast every morning and to her mom for picking her up whenever she needed. Trixie is grateful for her time spent involved in the performing arts, and she would like to thank all of her teachers. Girl power.
Mitchell Devine.
Mitch is going to miss his friends and would like to thank all the teachers and staff of Royal Bay Secondary for getting him here today.
Caitlin Doné.
Caitlin was a member of the Girls Lacrosse Academy from when it started. She was always looking forward to the trips with the girls. Caitlin always enjoyed going down to the beach during lunches as well as just sitting in the lot. Caitlin's going to be attending Camosun College for a criminology program this coming fall. And Caitlin would like to thank her parents for always pushing her in school.
Justin Drew.
Some people share 100% more of their DNA with bananas than other people, and it really shows. Justin would like to thank his siblings, especially his brother, for showing him what not to do while growing up. He would also like to thank his parents for raising him properly. Third time's a charm.
Aditya Easwarn.
Adi participated in many events and charities around the school and community. He was a leadership member throughout the high school. Adi is proud of the work he put into 10,000 Tonight and other events in the school and community.
Carson Eklund.
Carson would like to thank all of his friends for making school fun and to his smart friends for letting him copy off their work.
Sarah Fitzgerald.
Whenever she's about to do something, Sarah thinks, would an idiot do that? And if they would, she would not do that thing.
Peyton Forrest.
Peyton would like to thank all his teachers and staff for helping him throughout high school, especially Mr. Moyes. Shout out to him. He's been there for him since grade 7. Peyton's future goals include a gap year, then going to school in the States for lacrosse, or taking the electrical course at Camosun College. Oh yes, thanks Mom and Dad.
Kayla Fortin.
Kayla would like to say, success doesn't come from what you do occasionally. It comes from what you do consistently.
Alexis Gage.
Alexis Gage would like to thank her family and friends for all the love and support over the years. She plans to attend Camosun in the fall for the criminology program to hopefully pursue a career in policing. Special thank you to Mr. Hobson, Ms. White, Ms. Checkley, and Ms. McKinnon for always believing in her. Rock on, 2020 grads.
Indira Gardizi.
Indira plans on taking a gap year to travel around Europe and Asia. Afterwards, she wants to go to post-secondary to obtain a medical degree.
Grace Gardner.
Grace would like to thank all of her teachers that helped and inspired her to work hard and persevere through the ups and downs of high school. In particular, Ms. Snowcell and Mr. Whitney, who encouraged her to push herself and gain confidence that will help her rise to the challenges of the future. McKenna Gargas.
McKenna is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Physical Activity. She was a member of the senior girls basketball team. Her favorite memories are the team trips to Hawaii and provincials. McKenna is looking forward to completing a degree in science at the University of Victoria.
Taylor Golding.
Taylor would like to thank her family and friends for the endless support they've given her over the years. She will be studying kinesiology at the University of Victoria in September.
Megan Griffiths.
Meg would like you all to know how hard she tried to write something funny, but then she quickly realized how unfunny she is, so instead she decided to go with something generic.
She has had a great time these last 12 and a half years. She's met some really great people, that she'll never see again, and she is very thankful for all the opportunities she's been given. Meg has made so many great memories over the years. Lastly, she'd like to thank the teachers.
Rachel Gashiel.
Rachel is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Physical Activity. Rachel played on the Ravens basketball team through her 4 years at Royal Bay. She is grateful for all the friendships and memories made over the years and would like to thank her parents, coaches, and teachers for always supporting her. Rachel is looking forward to pursuing post-secondary education and traveling abroad in the future.
Julina Gilbo.
Julina would like to thank her close family and friends for their love and support throughout the years. She is eager to start at the University of Victoria in the fall of 2020, with the plans to become a high school teacher. She would like to also thank Mr. Burgess and Mr. Waterlander for helping her achieve some of her academic goals throughout her 4 years at Royal Bay. Big shout out to her parents and the girls for always being there.
Wesley Haberlin.
Mr. Haberlin would like to thank his family and friends for their support. He would also like to thank Lee Brassmore and perhaps Demings.
Simon Hadley.
After 4 years at Royal Bay, Simon is ready to move on to the next stage of his life. He would like to thank his family and Royal Bay staff for all their support.
Gary Hahn.
Gary was a member of the senior boys volleyball team and helped with training and scorekeeping.
Quinton Harrington.
Quinton is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Community Service, as well as the recipient of the West Shore RCMP Community Policing Helping Profession Scholarship. Quinton would like to thank Mr. Waterlander, Mr. Burgess, and his other grade 12 teachers for making his final year at Royal Bay a memorable one. He would also like to thank his friends for the many adventures.
Well, hello, graduating class of 2020, and congratulations. And it's Ed and Cliff here for the Q Morning Show, but don't worry, there will be other important people that will appear to you here during your graduation ceremony. So it is going to get better.
Well,
just know
that. Ed, it's interesting because not much has happened this year.
Yeah, it's been a pretty
it's just a normal world,
pretty
nothing
quiet.
Going on anywhere, anytime. Yeah. So it's not different at all.
No, really. It's a regular year.
It's so different that you and I are talking to these grads. That's how different it is, right?
Yes.
It's a different time.
That's how bizarre things have gotten, for sure. So we wanted to just congratulate all of you. I don't know that we have any words of advice as you carry on from school down the road of life, but maybe if you pattern your life by doing nothing that we've done, you might be okay. That might be a good way to go.
Well, that is good advice for sure. Although certainly, I've really enjoyed the career here, especially at the Q. I've been in radio and as Ed Heads for a long, long time. And maybe one thing that I've learned along the way, you know, at events like this, when people are talking about grad and moving forward in your life, I think the most important thing is try and keep an open mind. And you know, one thing I've learned along the way, it's very important to feel good about yourself and make good choices and really basically love yourself. I think that's a great way to be. You're going to face lots of challenges, but if you feel good about yourself, you're going to make good choices. And I think that's very, very important down the road. And please, if you could, I mean, Ed and I have been around for a while, really enjoy this time. This is such an important time in your lives, and there's so much to look forward to. In some ways, there's a lot of uncertainty right now, but believe me, Ed and I, we always talk about this. There is more good than bad in the world. Congratulations to all of you. You've worked so hard to get to this spot. Good luck in the future, and thanks for taking the time to pay attention to us. We appreciate it.
And I hope, you know, and you talked about how long we've done radio, and we're lucky that we found something we love to do. And I think that's key. If you can find something that you love, it will never really feel like work. And that's been the case. And thank God for radio for us, because I don't know, there'd be no other station interested in us other than Chevron, I think, if this industry didn't exist. But congratulations. All the best as the years carry on. And we have some real talent on the show, some actual local talent. The Machosen One is here. Please say hello to Jesse Roper.
Congratulations, 2020 grads, going to the world and be nice people.
There's never been a war caused by kindness. There's never been a wound suffered from acceptance and compromise. No, there's never been a life taken by the use of an open mind. It seems like understanding's hard to find. I read about a man who suffered for what he believed in. A dream about a day that bring equality to humankind. Somebody shot the man down for the thoughts in his mind. What happened to understanding? What about the dream of love? Oh no, never did the act of sharing this old world cause humanity to fall. I just want to live my life on the right side. I won't choose to believe in the quality of humankind. Cause there's going to be some hard times. Something's got to push me through the night. I just want to live now. I just want to survive this whole world. I just want to live on the bright side. Now we around the world know the feeling of mistrust. It's been bred for all the centuries in human lives. Got to break this chain if we ever gonna continue as a civilization. Got to break this chain, or just deepen the divide. Cause maybe there's a heaven up above or on the other side. And maybe there's a God who knows that we ain't never gonna understand or get along. I know we can't conceive to living like the one who calls the shots without the open mind. What about our children? How they gonna survive? Oh no, never become the same. You're gonna wait for them to change the tide. Oh, I just wanna live my life on the bright side. I wanna choose to believe in the goodness in humankind. Cause there's going to be some hot dogs, oh, in the fight and to survive. What if there's no heaven? What if there's no God? Oh no. What if there's no understanding? What this is all about. Can live this life on the bright side. And maybe we can choose to believe in the goodness in humankind. Because there's going to be some hard times. Something's got to push me through the night. I just want to live now. I just want all of us to survive this whole world. I just want to live. And I on the bright side.
Our first guest this afternoon is Mr. Ravi Parmar, who brings congratulations to the graduating class from the Souk School 62 Board of Education Trustee.
Hello, SD62 graduates and families. My name is Ravi Parmar, and I am here on behalf of your Board of Education. So honored to be joining you in this celebration of our graduating class of 2020. Graduates, I want to begin by acknowledging some important people in your lives. I want to celebrate and recognize the over 1,700 SD62 employees who work hard every day to ensure that we have the best school district in this province and ensure our students have the skills they need to succeed. I want to thank our teachers, counselors, EAs, custodians, clerical, bus drivers, trades and grounds crew, crossing guards and administrators, every employee in SD62 who all, no matter their task, play a crucial role in our collective success. I also want to, on behalf of the board, acknowledge your families, all of you watching this video in the comfort of your homes, parents, guardians and caregivers, grandparents, aunts and uncles, siblings and everyone else. Thank you for everything you have done to support your graduate reaching this moment. Your commitment to your child's education and trusting SD62 to deliver public education to your child here in our community. I'm sure there was never a shortage of challenges, but you always stuck by and were persistent in your support of your child and the work they do in our schools. I want to recognize all those parents that were involved in local PACs or the district PAC, and those who volunteered in our schools. I think we can all agree our schools would look a whole lot different if it wasn't for the dedication of our parents and families. So graduates, I want you to take this opportunity in whichever way you want, hug, eye contact, verbal expression, to thank your families for all they've done to support you in reaching this important milestone. Graduates, now I want to talk directly to you. These are interesting times we live in. No matter what goes on in our world, for some reason our society seems to enjoy measuring success, usually based off of how much money you have, the size of your home, how nice your car is, how perfect your family is, the list goes on. Grads, think about the life you want to have. Think about the goals you want to set. Where do you want to be in 5, 10, 50 years? Now you must be thinking, Ravi, what are you talking about? I'm just focused on tomorrow. And there's nothing wrong with that, especially in the unprecedented times we are living in. I want to leave you with a piece of advice. You define what success means to you. But don't let your family, friends, colleagues, society, or anyone else do that for you. You decide what success means to you. Set those goals and strive to achieve them, and you will be successful. You will be happy. And that's all that matters. As you travel through the journey of life, you will face challenges, obstacles, and heartbreak. We all do. You may feel you want to quit, but when you have that feeling, I want you to remember your community. Nelson Mandela, one of my heroes, once said, "Do not judge me by my success. Judge me by how many times I fell down and got back up." Like I said, you may feel the urge to quit, but just get back up. Easier said than done, right? If there's anything that I hope you take from your years in school, it's the values you have been taught by your educators and family. The value of respect, honesty, integrity, and resiliency. The late Barbara Bush, a former First Lady of the United States, once said, "Never lose sight of the fact that the most important yardstick of your success will be people, your family, friends, and coworkers, and even the strangers you meet along the way." I believe we all get meaning from our communities. They give us that sense that we are part of something bigger, that we are not alone. Graduates, your community surrounds you every day from a social and physical distance, but in your local grocery stores, in your neighborhood, everyone tuning into this video. By so many measures, our community is getting stronger and more prosperous than it ever was. And that is because of you. You, our leaders, are challenged every day to do better and to be better. But as I stand here virtually participating in this celebration, I know that you, graduates, are filled with courage and optimism. We need more of that. The graduating class of 2020 is filled with decent and generous people, and that is a constant message echoed by your community. I see people working hard and starting businesses. I see people teaching kids, serving our community, our province and country. I see engineers and tradespeople building and designing. and see doctors and nurses saving lives. The list goes on. I see a new generation full of energy and innovative ideas, ready to take on all of the problems this world has. No pressure. Graduates, you should be so proud. You are our community's most valuable assets. So for me, a humble congratulations on this important milestone in your lives. Enjoy this moment. Have some fun, be safe, and continue to listen to Dr. Bonnie Henry. On behalf of your Board of Education and community, congratulations. And remember, when you fall down, we as a community will be there to help get you back up.
Thank you, Mr. Parmer.
Our next guest is Mr. Scott Stinson, Superintendent of School District 62.
Greetings to you, our graduating class of 2020. From all of our secondary schools in SD 62, Royal Bay, Belmont, Edward Milne, and West Shore, congratulations on your graduation. While your graduation ceremonies this year may look different than other years, it still does not diminish the tremendous accomplishments that you've been able to make to this point. You've worked hard to get yourselves where you are now, and I recognize that that drive and determination to accomplish this comes with sacrifices, and none more so now than the work you're doing to keep everyone safe and healthy. So thank you for that. I get the distinct privilege today to be able to do three things: to bring acknowledgement and congratulations from the employees of SD 62, to be able to acknowledge and honor you as graduates from our school district this year, and to be able to offer you a small piece of advice. Take it in the spirit that it's intended. First of all, as you go forward into your next set of opportunities, always remember the school district staff that have been here to support you all along your way. Whether it's a teacher, a crossing guard, a vice principal, or any of the countless other employees that we have in the school district, they've been here to help you to get where you are now. On behalf of the over 1,600 employees in our school district, I offer you their congratulations. You were always destined to be a unique graduating class. Even before the obvious came along, as staff got to know you through your applications to scholarships, to post-secondary institutions, and through your capstone projects, we've seen the tremendous accomplishments that you've been able to achieve in your lives already. And we look forward to the many possibilities yet to come. With your grade 12 year upended by a worldwide pandemic, you will truly stand alone as the grad class of 2020. There will be no other grad class like you that anyone can compare to. Now for that small piece of advice. Take it in the spirit that it's intended to help you see beyond this day and this event to the rest of your life. As you move away from the structures of public education, you will be making more decisions for yourself. Some of those decisions will be good. Some of those will be decisions that you wonder what you were thinking at the time. But I would encourage you to try new things and embrace new ways of thinking. Sometimes in life, we become comfortable with what we have and where we are now. This world has so much to offer, so much to see, so much to do. Go out and take advantage of it. Our current situation won't last forever. These opportunities will be there. Take advantage when they come along. Life is meant to be lived and experienced. So start now in making those memories that you'll reflect on a life well lived. So to you, our graduates, congratulations once again. You are now an SD 62 graduate, and that means something in this world. Go forward, be proud of who you are and what you will accomplish. Congratulations.
And thank you, Mr. Stinson. It is my pleasure to introduce our special guest who will be addressing the graduation class. Please join me in welcoming Mitzi Dean, member of the Legislative Assembly for Esquimalt Metchosin.
Hi, grads of 2020. I'd like to start by acknowledging that I represent Songhees and Esquimalt Nations and Chianu, and I'm very honoured and privileged to work on their traditional territory. And all of our schools are on different traditional territories of different Indigenous peoples, and we're very grateful and honoured to be able to do our work across this beautiful region. So I'm really excited to tell you how proud I am and to say congratulations to all of you for your amazing graduation this year. I know there have been some adventures, I'm sure there have been some sacrifices as well, and it's a marvelous milestone, and you should all be very proud of yourselves and pleased that you've all supported each other to get to this as well. And let's say a special thank you to everybody who has supported each and every one of you to reach this amazing milestone. Let's also mention the elephant in the room. My heart goes out to everybody in this time of pandemic with the COVID-19 virus in our community. I can't imagine what it feels like to you to be graduating in this year. I'm sure everything looks very different than how you'd expected. And I also do hope that you are finding ways to find ceremony and celebration and support each other, because this is a really important time for you and things will continue. So let's keep looking to the positives. And I'm so excited for your futures and I really envision wonderful things for all of you. So again, I want to say congratulations. I wish you the very best and I hope to see you again sometime.
Riley Hawes.
Riley was a member of the Junior and Senior Boys Lacrosse Academy. He was honored in bringing home the first Royal Bay Lacrosse Provincial Championship title, along with many other Royal Bay Lacrosse Academy accomplishments. Riley will be attending Camosun College in the fall to complete his refrigeration mechanic course.
Kiana Hepburn.
Kiana will be attending UVic to pursue a career in psychology.
Karis Hainsbroek.
Karis will be attending the Faculty of Science for Chemistry at the University of Victoria, and she would like to thank Mr. Booth and Ms. Pushka for their support.
Monica Johns.
Monica was often found roaming the hallways and socializing with friends and Mr. Burgess. She cannot wait to see what the future holds and is excited to make more memories with the people she loves the most. Hasta la vista, Royal Bay.
Mason Johnson.
Mason is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Physical Activity. Mason says, you got to roll with the punches and get to what's real.
Riley Johnson.
Riley enjoyed his time at Royal Bay, but is now looking forward to the visual arts program at Camosun.
Caitlin Jordison.
Katie was only at Royal Bay for 1 year. She enjoyed her time and is so excited to move on to the next stage of life. A big thank you to Mr. Moyes. She couldn't have done it without his support.
Sharon Kurtawijaya.
Sharon will be attending UVic this year and is excited to start a new chapter in her life. She would like to thank her family and friends for helping her get through high school.
Dylan Kickbush.
Dylan's favorite pastimes were playing soccer, basketball, and hanging out with his friends. He is excited to graduate and move on to the next stage in life.
Jessa Kujak.
Jessa is graduating early and will be taking a gap year. She would like to thank her family and friends for all their support. Jessa wishes all the grads the best of luck.
Jaden Curvers.
Jaden was a member of the senior boys basketball team and now plans to study business at the University of Victoria.
Jet Lamb.
Jet will be attending the University of Victoria this fall and has enrolled in their engineering program. He has enjoyed his time at Royal Bay and would like to wish everyone the best of luck in their future endeavors.
Riley Lamb.
The 4 years Riley has spent at Royal Bay have been some of the best years of his life. A few of his favorite memories are the band trip to Cuba, playing trumpet with Wes and Andrew, performing in the musical theater and soccer academy. He has made some great friends and has had amazing experiences. Riley wishes all the Royal Bay graduates the best of luck in their future plans. As Walt Disney said, all our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them.
Isaac Lamondon.
Isaac would like to wish all the grads of 2020 the best of luck.
Ava Lamont.
Ava would like to thank her parents for their unwavering support over the years. She would also like to thank Mr. Froese for being her favorite teacher at Royal Bay. Ava plans to attend UVic this fall, studying for a degree in history. She would like to continue traveling with hopes of working and furthering her studies in Europe.
Maya Landers.
Maya was a member of Grad Council and the senior girls soccer team, which had a real start to the season this year. She thanks all her teachers, especially from her grade 11 and 12 years, that have helped her become a better student and person. She will be attending Camosun and UVic for the nursing program with some of her friends for the fall.
Dylan Larratt.
Dylan would like to say congratulations to everyone. Evan Law.
Evan would like to thank his friends and family for getting him through four of the best years of his life. He's looking forward to another four fun years at University of Victoria, where he'll be taking the Bachelor of Commerce program.
Rosita Lurk-Velikel.
Rosita will attend university in England and use everything she learned during school to study film. She appreciated her friends, teachers, and her host family for supporting and helping her with everything. Due to the COVID-19 situation, she would like to remind everyone to stay safe and healthy.
Graydon Lindsay.
Graydon is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Tech and Trades Training. Graydon was a member of multiple school bands throughout his 4 years at Royal Bay and has been passionate about technology ever since his first class in the subject. Graydon is planning to pursue computer science at the University of Victoria.
Rio Liu.
Rio is the recipient of the Victor Chan Memorial Engineering Scholarship, as well as one of the District Authority Scholarships for Tech and Trades Training. Even though he secretly wants to live in the fourth dimension, he still will interact with the third dimension universe as long as he's here. Rio participated in the robotics club since grade 9 and has been to several competitions with the team. After graduation, Rio is planning to study more in astrophysics and engineering, hoping to build a swimming pool on the moon one day.
Madison Lowe.
Madison is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for International Languages. Madison would like to thank her family and friends for helping her through this journey. Next year, she will be attending the University of Victoria in their commerce program to get her business degree.
Maria Malik.
Maria would like to thank her family and friends for all the love and support over the years. Maria is looking forward to her next chapter of completing her nursing degree and traveling. One of her favorite memories of high school was going to France with her French class.
Derek Margeson.
Maya Angelou once said, "We as human beings at our best can only create opportunities." So Derek would like to take this opportunity and thank those who helped him get to where he is today. His teachers and all his friends who gave him the confidence to continue with his passion he's held for years, writing. Derek will never forget the support he's been given academically and socially.
Madison Marsh.
Madison is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Community Service. Madison was a member of the girls' volleyball and soccer teams throughout her high school years. She would like to thank her mom, dad, sister, and friends for supporting her, and she is looking forward to what the future holds.
Taylor Martin.
Taylor is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Physical Activity. Taylor will be attending UVic this fall to get her BA in psychology. Taylor would like to thank her mom, dance instructors, and Burgess for supporting her throughout these past 4 years.
Hannah Moll.
Hannah was a member of the Royal Bay Dance Academy from grade 9 to 11. Hannah would like to thank her teachers, family, and friends. Shout out to the homies for all of their support.
Liam McBride.
I'm only here so I don't get fined.
Ellie McConnell.
Ellie will be studying psychology at UVic in the fall. She wants to thank Mr. Sims for teaching her about rock and roll and Mr. Froze for preparing her for post-secondary.
Sarah McCormick.
Sarah is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts. Sarah is excited to attend the University of Victoria this fall to begin working on her Bachelor of Science on her journey to becoming an elementary school teacher. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for all their support during her years at Royal Bay.
Sean Meehan.
Sean has enjoyed his 2 years at Royal Bay. He would like to thank the teachers and staff for a great experience. He plans to take a gap year and to continue to play junior hockey. Chloe Michalski.
Chloe would like to thank her family for supporting her with all her passions. She would like to give a shout out to her friends for making these years filled with laughter. Chloe loved being a part of the Lacrosse Academy and would like to thank Coach Brittany and Weeding for making each class one to look forward to. Chloe plans on becoming an occupational therapist and will start her Bachelor's of Science degree part-time at the University of Victoria. Chloe is thrilled to have accepted a scholarship to play NCAA lacrosse in Tennessee starting in the fall of 2021. While on the field, she can't wait to continue breaking the ankles of her opponents. Catch you on the flippity flip.
Alicia Mitchell.
Alicia was part of the band and volleyball program throughout high school, and in these programs she found friends whom she now considers family.
Kennedy Mitchell.
Kennedy is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Applied Skills, Design, and Technology, as well as one of the recipients of the Royal Bay PAC Bursary Awards. Kennedy would like to thank Mr. Froese, Signora, and Mr. Burgess for being outstanding role models to her. Kennedy is looking forward to living with her best friend and attending UVic for digital art in the fall.
Kyra Mitchell Kennedy.
Kyra was a proud member of the Royal Bay Music Department during her years at Royal Bay and would like to thank Ms. Snowsell and Mr. Whitney, as well as all other faculty members, for making her high school experience a memorable one. Kyra is looking forward to her coming years as a student at the University of Victoria and hopes to continue with music in the future. Kyra is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts.
Grace Malacker.
Grace would like to wish all the grads of 2020 the best of luck.
Rachel Moore.
Rachel is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts. Rachel spent all her time in school to finally be able to bask in the freedom from it all for one summer before she goes back to school for 8 more years. She is starting at the University of Victoria in the fall for a degree in psychology and moving on to pursue a medical degree in psychiatry. Rachel hopes to apply her passion for art in her career as well as continue to grow as an artist.
Owen Morgan.
Owen would like to thank all the teachers who helped him through to graduation, and good luck to all the grads and his friends.
Sierra Moriarty.
Sierra was an enthusiastic member of the senior acting company throughout her years at Royal Bay. She is looking forward to beginning her studies at Camosun College and helping others using her psychology degree.
Matthew Morneau.
Matthew, or Dougie, as his friends refer to him, has been a member of the Lacrosse Academy for the past 4 years. When he's not at school or work, Matt can be found either playing video games or partying with his friends. Matt aspires to become a millionaire so he can buy whatever he wants.
Alexander Morrell.
Thanks to Royal Bay, Alexander has an opportunity to thrive in the outside world. He's grateful for the teachers who have put time and effort into his future, even if some of the info went in one ear and out the other. Goodbye and good luck.
Connor Morrison.
In the words of Bertuzzi, it is what it is.
Nyla Morton.
Nyla would like to say thank you to all the teachers and staff at Royal Bay for making her high school experience so good.
Keith Murchison.
Keith enjoys computer science and is looking forward to university. Thank you to the teachers, his family, and the Bruno Boesio family. Happy graduation, everyone.
Chelsea Musgrave.
Chelsea would like to thank her family, friends, and loved ones who couldn't be here today for all the love and support throughout her years at Royal Bay. She looks forward to all the possibilities before her.
Georgia Miles.
Georgia is going to UVic to get an environmental studies degree and would like to thank Mrs. Pushka and her parents for inspiring her.
Vivian Nguyen.
Vivian is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Community Service, as well as the recipient of the John Stubbs Memorial PAC Bursary, and one of the recipients of the Rotary Club of West Shore Scholarships.
Vivian would like to thank her family, teachers, and coaches for all their support throughout the years. She would especially like to thank her sister, Vienna, for always being someone she could look up to. Vivian will be attending McGill University in the fall and hopes to pursue a career in neuroscience.
Dallas Nichols.
Dallas has loved his time at Royal Bay and has been a part of the soccer academy all through high school and also on the senior boys soccer team. Dallas has been on the honor roll and the principal's honor roll every semester throughout high school and plans to begin his post-secondary journey in September 2020. After graduating, he has just one question. What happened to Mr. Sunder?
Megan O'Brien.
Megan would like to thank her friends and family for showing her love and support over the past 4 years. Megan would also like to thank her teachers for encouraging her to succeed. Megan plans to travel and, starting in 2021, attend Camosun for criminal justice. Cheers to the class of 2020.
Amelia Ooms.
Throughout her time at Royal Bay, Amelia has enjoyed her classes and spending time with her friends. Amelia is excited to be attending the University of Victoria in the Faculty of Education this fall.
Cody Parkinson.
Cody was a member of the boys basketball team all 4 years at Royal Bay.
Evan Pasemko.
Evan actively participated in cadets throughout his years of high school. He earned a spot on the national rifle team, competing in Bisley, England, summer of 2019. Evan plans to finish his cadet career here in Victoria next year before pursuing post-secondary studies in game design at the Vancouver Film School. One of his fondest memories was participating in 10,000 Tonight in grade 10. We won.
Wyatt Powells.
Wyatt's favorite classes were PE and metalwork. In March, Wyatt entered a Skills Canada welding competition at Camosun College and placed third. Wyatt is planning to pursue a career in welding and fabrication, and he would like to thank Mr. Craven for all his help over the past 3 years.
William Perrier.
Will was a member of the Lacrosse Academy. He competed throughout high school and is very excited to continue his lacrosse career and education at St. Ambrose University in Iowa, where he will study business.
Matthew Pletch.
Matthew will soon be a weapons tech for the Canadian Army. He would like to thank Stefan for being a great multi-sport and super fit teacher. Everyone take care and stay safe.
Eli Pahoney.
Eli would like to wish the grads of 2020 the best of luck.
Shane Query.
Shane has been on the basketball team for all 4 years, making so many memories with his teammates he won't forget. Shane is going to take some time off to travel and explore the world.
Talia Quinn.
Talia has had a very eventful high school experience. She spent her high school years in Ontario, the Bahamas, and here at Royal Bay. In the future, she'd like to travel to Japan and teach foreign languages as a career.
Skyra Rankatrasit.
Skyra would like to share this special quote. Understanding is the first step to acceptance, and only with acceptance can there be recovery. Albus Dumbledore. McKenna Renault Kehoe.
McKenna would like to wish all the grads of 2020 the best of luck.
Amelia Robertson.
Amelia would like to wish all the grads of 2020 the best of luck.
Justin Robinson.
Justin would like to thank Mr. Whitney, Ms. Pushka, Mr. Baldwin, as well as every other teacher who helped him succeed through high school. He would be nowhere near as motivated to succeed without the endless support they all gave him. Just some thanks, every friend who stuck with him along the way. He'll never forget the memories they made, even the little things like the boys' concert in Deming's class or pushing through the cafeteria to get cookies every day.
Lauren Robinson.
Lauren would like to thank her dog Duke and her mom for getting her through school and all of life's struggles. Hakuna Matata, loves.
Kevin Royal.
Kevin is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts, as well as one of the recipients of the Soup Teachers Association Scholarship and one of the Royal Bay PAC bursaries. After 12 years of school, Kevin has decided not to only pursue further education, but also a career in teaching. You either die a hero or you live long enough to see yourself become the villain.
Eve Ruth.
Eve is one of the recipients of a district authority scholarship for tech and trades training. Eve would like to thank the people who made the past 4 years enjoyable. High school has been good, but it's over now, and that's even better. Goodbye, Royal Bay.
Oh, class 2020. Imagine if something super weird was going on that then the history books would remember you guys forever.
That's right.
Anyway. Hey, it's Dylan and Jason from The Zone Morning Show on The Zone at 91.3, and congratulations, everybody.
Congratulations, everybody. See what I did there?
I begged him not to do that.
Yeah, well, I did it anyway.
And here we are.
Listen, everyone, we hope you have an awesome graduation. I know it's weird. I know it's a little frustrating. Maybe you have to do it from home, the isolation. Hopefully, you'll get a chance to party real soon. If it's any consolation, Dee and I didn't have the greatest time out there partying. My graduation night, I ended up with like a terrible sunburn, a twisted ankle, hazy memories. It was a whole thing.
He gave me the details, parents. Trust me, he's doing a public service by not indulging the story.
I don't get asked to chaperone a lot of things.
No. Yeah, you know what? To be honest, I had to do this weird in-person ceremony graduation. And I blew the entire crotch out of my pants the first 10 minutes. No joke. I had to sit on the front of the main stage the whole time, give two speeches, and I had a massive hole. So I'm envious, actually. Consider yourselves lucky as you sit at home half naked. Enjoy it.
Yes, enjoy it. And please go out in the world and make some good changes. We really need that right now. We're counting on the younger people to fix all the awful mistakes that people like him made.
Yeah, no, you're likely catching a whiff of some pretty weird things going on. We're really counting on you. Be better than us. Congratulations, grads of 2020. You guys are incredible. And truly, you will look back on this moment in time. Very unique. So congratulations for getting through it all. And
we didn't mention that we're both Victoria grads,
by the
way.
Yeah.
Oak Bay High, 88, yo.
Woo! Claremont Spartans, 98. Fly like a butterfly.
That's not their school slogan, but...
I tried.
Yeah, you tried.
I tried to get it.
Didn't really take off. Anyway, we're supposed to introduce Carmana, aren't we?
Great friends of ours, incredibly talented musicians. You're in for a wonderful treat. Actually, Laura is Claremont alumni as well.
So
looks like Claremont won this round.
Jeff Cortinel.
Damn it. Congratulations. This is Carmana, grad 2020. Way to go.
It is my pleasure to introduce our special guest who will be addressing the graduating class. Please join me in welcoming the Premier of British Columbia, Mr. John Horgan.
To the graduating classes of 2020 at Edward Milne, Belmont, and Royal Bay, I want to wish you all the best in the days and weeks and months and, in fact, years ahead. All of you have come through an extraordinary time. Obviously, being graduates of a pandemic make you unique in our history. But you're also unique in the fact that you all come together at one time in our history where we need you more than ever. You are going to be the next carpenters, nurses, doctors, entrepreneurs, poets. You name it, you have the opportunity to be it. Many of you will go traveling for a month or two or a year. Many of you will go right to work. Many of you will decide that you want to take a couple of months off. Some will go to university. Some will go to college. Whatever you want to do, you can do. The pandemic will not hold you back. The pandemic will define who you are going forward. These are extraordinary times for British Columbians, for Canadians, and indeed around the world. But the class of 2020 is set apart from all other classes that have come before you and those that will come after you. You are unique, you are special, you are extraordinary. Normally we gather in large crowds, your parents, your grandparents, and all of those who have supported you come to say congratulations. That has not changed. We're not gathering in large groups, but the sense of accomplishment that you feel today is as special now as it will be a year from now or 2 years from now. Graduating from high school is a rite of passage. It sends you from your childhood into your adulthood. Now, I know many of you are thinking, I've been an adult for a long time, and maybe that's true. But when you say goodbye to Edward Milne, to Belmont, and to Royal Bay, you're saying goodbye to friends you've had sometimes from 5 years old on, from kindergarten all the way through. And that's a sad day, but it's also a time for celebration. I believe this is going to be your year. 2020 will define who you are as you go forward into whatever endeavor you choose to follow. We're all proud of you. We're all counting on you. And as I say at graduation ceremonies year after year after year, I am the creator of the bad dad joke. We need you to get into the economy as quickly as possible because your parents and grandparents are going to need hip and knee replacements and our public healthcare system won't run itself. We need you to be in there making sure that those things that define us as Canadians continue now and into the future. All the best, class of 2020. Pandemic, be darned. Let's go on. Have a great evening. Have a great week. Have a great celebration wherever you may do it, whether it's on Zoom or some other piece of technology. But know you've accomplished something extraordinary, and we're all fiercely proud of you.
Hello, class of 2020, and congratulations on graduating. You've worked hard to get here, and you should be proud of everything you've accomplished. I know this wasn't how you thought you were going to celebrate this moment. You had plans to walk across the stage with your diploma in hand and hope in your heart, with your parents, teachers, and coaches watching proudly, and your friends cheering you on. You were looking forward to dressing up for prom and dancing the night away. But even if today is different than you planned, I want you to know that this moment is still very special. Because nothing can take away the hard work it took to get here, not even a global pandemic. Now, I know that the last few months have made the future seem more uncertain. That summer job you were hoping to get might be a little more difficult to find, and your plans to go off to college or university in the fall might look different. The truth is, these are challenging times. But you were made for moments like this. Across this country, we've seen you take to the streets demanding action on climate change. You've joined millions to keep moving us forward on gender equality, and you've stood up against intolerance and hate. And daily, you challenge us all how we think about mental health. Your generation will continue the fight for a more just and equal world. Your passion and your dreams will shape what our future can and should look like. Class of 2020, this is still your year to shine. You have all the tools you need to make your dreams a reality, and you have friends and loved ones who will be there for you as you pursue them. So as you start this next chapter in your life, remember that you have the power to change Canada and the world for the better. You're not just the leaders of tomorrow, you're the leaders of today. Your time is now, and I can't wait to see what you'll do next. Once again, congratulations.
I would now like to introduce Mr. Mike Huck, the principal of Royal Bay Secondary.
Welcome families, guests, and graduates to the Royal Bay graduation video, celebrating the achievements of our 2020 graduates. Thank you, Brother Rick Peter. Your teachings and wisdom have a tremendous impact on our children and staff. My name is Mike Huck, and as the very lucky and proud principal, I would like to welcome you to the Royal Bay graduation ceremony. I would like to begin by acknowledging and thanking the Coast Salish peoples for sharing this beautiful land with us as we learn and grow together. Haishka. I'm very honored to be here today as today is a special day for our graduates and also for their families who have supported them over the last 13 years of formal education and learning. These 13 years have been filled with many firsts and have laid the foundations through relationships, experience, and learning for the rest of your lives. I've been continuously inspired and amazed by your abilities, level of engagement, commitment, and potential. Most recently, I witnessed your compassion for one another and the surrounding communities as you've come together to support each other during these difficult weeks. You've emerged as a strong-voiced, focused, and resilient group of young adults. And as an educational system, we couldn't ask for more. You have handled disappointments and obstacles with grace and class. Well done. Since my return to Royal Bay, I have witnessed many amazing accomplishments coming from you. Throughout the music events, sporting events, and theatrical performances, you have shined. Your social mindedness has shown through in the way that, as a grad group, you have supported the initiatives in the community, like our mental awareness events and 10,000 Tonight. In every aspect and in every part of the school, you have become leaders, and you have left a lasting mark on our school. Wow. You are an incredible bunch. In the classroom of scientists, sustainability and social warriors, engineers, outdoor enthusiasts, future teachers, musicians and artists, or authors, or in the gym on the field as future Olympians and coaches, the countless hours of practice and rehearsal for performances in dance, music, and theater, or as tradespeople, working in the apprentices like carpentry and joinery, culinary arts, and welding and forging, and supporting your community as volunteers in our local food drives and fundraising, you represent the very best of us. I thought that it would be important to share some things I've learned along the way with you. As you are confronted with stressful times, deadlines, and change over the duration of your life, see the most difficult and stressful times as opportunities for great and deep learning, good and bad. What I've come to realize is that we often learn most when we fail. Truly successful people don't merely tolerate discomfort, they seek it out again and again. Your mindset matters. Perseverance, resilience, and commitment are skills that will see you through to success. I have witnessed and know all of our staff have acted in loco parentis, Latin for in place of parents. And like your families, we are so very proud of the young people that you have become. Your reaction to the shutdown that we have all faced has been noticed by us all. It was evident from the start that you could be counted on to carry on what you finished. We knew that you were a strong and committed group, but your response over the last several weeks has simply been inspirational. You took it in stride, you put your heads down, and you simply got on with what mattered. We look forward to listening to your narrative as you grow. It is often when you visit years from now, or we meet each other in the airport lobby, we get to see the person that you've become. Over a brief, hey, how are you? What have you been doing? Please trust that we really appreciate these moments. I would like to acknowledge that this video is not what you expected. However, the journey that brings you today was filled with the unexpected. I want to encourage you that is during times of challenge or unexpected change that your life journey is presented with a choice. And it is what you do with this choice and in a month ahead that can alter the trajectory of your life. The fact is, life throws us a lot of curves. But you have already proven you're a resilient bunch and able to adjust to circumstances out of your control. No prom, no in-class school, and a graduation ceremony that certainly looks different from what we've had in the past. But I hope it is times like this that remind us what is really important in our lives. Things like caring, looking out for others who are hurting, compassion, compromise, and courage. Most importantly, an inner strength to never quit and never walk away. These qualities are clearly evident in the Royal Bay grad class of 2020. This moment in time will pass, but the lasting impression that it will leave on you will give you the strength and determination to move mountains. We are so proud of you. In closing, I would like to thank a few people on the behalf of the grad class and myself, Larissa Coates, Marianne Chase, and Michelle Scoville, for all the time that you spent on our PAC. Your commitment and care for the students and staff at Royal Bay and the district are evident. Ms. Glanfield, a counseling team, and the careers team for their support and dedication to our students in applying for scholarships and bursaries and post-secondary entrance and career and trades opportunities. Our clerical team for all their support and care for our kids. Our leadership team, Mike Bobbitt, Mark Johnson, Martin Late, and John Many, for the care and guidance and relationships that you forge with students on a daily basis. Graduates, please know your families, our staff, and our community are very, very proud of you and the people that you've become. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Jaden Sanford.
Jaden is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Community Service. Jaden is very excited to start the next chapter of her life at Camosun, where she'll be studying business and going further into human resources. She would like to thank Mr. Burgess for encouraging her to take on relationship roles and for helping her find her path.
Cole Saunders.
Cole would like to thank Royal Bay Secondary School.
Grace Scheid.
Grace hasn't always been committed to school, but she is ecstatic to become a paramedic.
Taya Scorey.
Taya is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Physical Activity. Taya would like to thank the countless teachers, coaches, friends, and family members who supported her through her years. Next year, she will be attending Queen's University and working towards a Bachelor of Arts while playing on the varsity soccer team.
Jordan Scoville.
Jordan has been on the principal's honor roll each term at Royal Bay. She has been an active musician in the band program, playing baritone in concert band and trombone in the jazz band and pit orchestra for school musicals. Jordan was also a part of many sports teams. She played 4 years of volleyball, basketball, ultimate, and 2 years of lacrosse. Jordan has traveled with the Ravens to Calgary, Edmonton, Palm Springs, Hawaii, Cuba, and France, and is grateful for her coaches, teachers, family, and teammates for the opportunity and memories these trips have given her.
Raisha Selathumbi.
Raisha is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Community Service. In her senior year at Royal Bay, Raisha performed in the production of Cabaret and planned many events as an international ambassador. Raisha would like to thank her friends, teacher, and family for the endless support. In the fall, Rachel will be attending the University of Victoria to become a lawyer. Raisha wants everyone to know that if they need legal advice, she's the person to call in about 10 years.
Mackenzie Sellers.
Mackenzie was a hardworking student who focused on his studies. He looks forward to furthering his education at the University of Victoria.
Juna Shepherd.
Juna would like to thank Ms. Vincent, Madame LaRue, Mr. Burgess, Mr. Sims, Mr. Demings, and Mr. Scott Moncrief for their encouragement in his favorite subjects, history, languages, and law. Juna is looking forward to attending UVic and to do some traveling to far-off places on and off the beaten path.
Riley Sherwood.
Riley was a member of the girls' basketball and volleyball teams and volunteered as an assistant soccer coach at the Wanda Fuca Rec Center. She was a member of the leadership, ambassador, and grad councils. Riley is going to continue her education at a university in BC in pursuit of an iron ring.
Bryce Sim.
Bryce would like to thank his family and friends for supporting him and looks forward to his future.
Madeline Sim.
Madeline would like to thank her friends and family for supporting her over the past 4 years. She looks forward to attending Camosun College next year and starting the next chapter of her life.
Bryn Smith.
Bryn is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Community Service, as well as one of the recipients of the Can West Scholarships. Bryn has been a member of the soccer and volleyball teams throughout her time at Royal Bay. She will be attending post-secondary in the fall and wishes everyone in her grad class all the best.
Madison Smith.
After much hard work, Madison is graduating a year early. It wasn't easy, but she doesn't regret it. She has many people to thank for supporting her on her journey.
Cairo Smythe.
Cairo would like to wish all the grads of 2020 the best of luck.
Victoria Smythe.
Victoria is grateful for the opportunity she's had to explore different things at school and is now looking forward to getting out and exploring different things in the world.
Cadence Noblin.
Caden was a member of the senior boys volleyball team and is also a lifeguard at JDF. His passion for biology led him to pursue a career in the medical field. He's excited to begin his Bachelor of Science in Nursing at Camosun in the fall. He would like to thank all the amazing teachers and coaches he has had here at Royal Bay and his awesome friends that made these past 4 years so memorable.
Nicholas Snowden.
Nick wants to thank his friends, family, and teachers who helped him on his path to graduation and as he starts his first few years at UVic.
Armand Sohi.
Armand was a member of the Lacrosse Academy and a teacher assistant for the Junior Lacrosse Academy throughout his high school years. Armand is looking forward to completing his science degree at the University of Victoria. He hopes this last year will be a reminder of all the great things he has done and all that he has yet to accomplish.
Aiden Solomon.
Aiden was a member of the Royal Bay Lacrosse Academy, which he loved for all 4 years. He will be pursuing a mechanical engineering degree at the University of Indianapolis and playing lacrosse next year.
Jet Stillings.
Jet would like to wish all the grads of 2020 the best of luck.
Lachlan Straith.
Lachlan is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts. Lachlan would like to thank all the teachers, staff, and family that made graduation possible, especially during these strange and uncertain times. Also, a huge thank you to Mr. Moyes for all the extra help. Lachlan is excited to start the next chapter creating art and traveling. Good luck to all the grads of 2020. Peace out.
Michaela Strandberg.
Michaela is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Physical Activity, as well as one of the recipients of the Can West Scholarships. Michaela was a member of the soccer and basketball teams at Royal Bay. She would like to thank Mr. Harris and Mr. Harrington for being such great mentors. She looks forward to attending McGill University in the fall.
Charlotte Strickland.
After graduation, Charlotte will be participating in Latitude's Global Volunteering Program in England. Charlotte's enjoyed being a part of the senior girls' soccer team and spending time with her friends. She'd like to send a special thank you to Mr. Whitney for his amazing support that allowed her to have a positive outlook through music.
Abigail Sutton.
Abby would like to say a thank you to all who helped her through high school. She wouldn't have gotten to where she is today without you.
Avery Sutton.
Avery is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Community Service. Avery is the co-captain of the Royal Bay Girls Lacrosse Academy team and holds the school record for both overall points and goals. She has also been on the principal's honor roll for the past 4 years, maintaining a 97% GPA. Avery received a scholarship to the University of Toronto and membership into the Trinity One program, where she will be completing a degree in international relations. Avery would like to thank her family and friends for their continuous support.
Shelley Tano.
Shelley was a devoted art student with an interest in storytelling. She partook in several opportunities, such as the Coast Collective and Souk Fine Arts, as well as showcasing her work within the school environment. Her hopes are to one day contribute her skills in future pieces of media for others to enjoy.
Alexander Taylor.
Alex has enjoyed being part of the robotics club and playing hockey at Wanda Fuca as a goalie. At the skills competition, he placed first in mechanical engineering. Alex is looking forward to taking criminal justice at Camosun College in pursuit of a career in law enforcement.
Braylon Terrio.
Braylon looks forward to traveling and seeing the world. He would like to thank his family and friends for their support, and a special thank you to his teacher, Lindsay L., for getting him through his grade 12 year and helping him graduate early.
Brianne Thompson.
Brianne is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Community Service, as well as one of the recipients of the QP459 bursary and one of the recipients of the CanWest scholarships. There is a reason this is called a commencement ceremony. Graduation is not the end, it is the beginning, Orrin Hatch. Brianne looks forward to her future coaching and volunteering at Wanda Fuca Skating Club and continuing to figure skate competitively. Brianne wants to thank her parents, coaches Mr. Froese, and her dog for helping her get through the past 4 years. Brianne plans to attend UVic and UBC, majoring in biochemistry to become a compounding pharmacist.
Bethany Tran.
Beth has greatly enjoyed her time at Royal Bay and wants to thank Mr. Whitney and Ms. Snowcell for furthering her passion for music. She looks forward to attending UVic in the fall for music education to become a secondary school music teacher, much like her mentor. She would also like to give a shout out to Cass for being there for her ever since day one.
Robin Troyer.
Robin is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts. Robin enjoyed her 4 years at Royal Bay. Robin will be attending UVic in September for the science program and hopes to attend UBC in the following years. She wants to thank all her teachers for all the support over the years.
Jalen Vanderlee.
Jalen is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts. Jalen was a member of the Advanced Placement Art class and has a piece featured in the Souk Fine Arts show. She is excited to see where her skills take her in the future when she attends Camosun and would like to thank her friends, family, and teachers who supported her along the way.
Paige Vizina.
Paige was a part of the Dance Academy and will remember all of her teachers at Royal Bay.
Miley Vu.
Miley is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts. Miley was a part of Royal Bay's Blackwing Theatre Company. She is looking forward to completing a degree in writing at the University of Victoria and pursuing her dreams of becoming a filmmaker.
Lauren Wagner.
Lauren is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for International Languages. Lauren is excited to continue her education at UVic and would like to thank her parents and teachers for helping her achieve this milestone.
Carly Ward.
Carly is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts. Carly is hoping to pursue a career in forensic anthropology by achieving her PhD through schooling in Camosun and the University of Toronto. She wants to thank all her teachers and friends for making her high school experience so memorable, and a special thanks to Ms. Harrington and Mr. Sims.
Nakoda Ward.
Nakoda enjoyed his time in the Soccer Academy at Royal Bay and is excited to study business next year and complete a Bachelor of Commerce degree.
Andrew Whitney.
Andrew is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for Fine Arts, as well as one of the recipients of the Rotary Club of West Shore Scholarship, and one of the Souk Teachers Association Scholarships, and the Ravenous Cafe Scholarship. Andrew took pride in being heavily involved with the music department, theater department, and volleyball team throughout his 4 years at Royal Bay. He is thankful for all the friendships and the memories he has made as a result. He is very much looking forward to attending Camosun College and hanging with the boys at Dogs.
Evan Wright.
Evan is one of the recipients of the District Authority Scholarship for International Languages. Evan has enjoyed 4 years at Royal Bay Secondary. He would like to thank his mentor, Ms. Pushka, and Senora Haddon for helping him throughout high school. He will be studying engineering at the University of Victoria next year.
Logan Wright.
Logan has been a part of the Royal Bay Lacrosse Academy throughout his 4 years in high school. A special thank you to his coaches and teammates for creating great experiences and bonds that will last a lifetime. Logan is excited to see what the future holds for him. He would also like to take a minute to appreciate his amazing parents for all their love and support.
Cameron York.
Cam was a member of the Royal Bay Lacrosse Academy for 4 years. He enjoyed all his time spent with teammates and coaches. Cam plans to travel after graduation with friends.
To talk to us of the accomplishments of the past, as well as the challenges we may face in the future, here are Mohammed Abogani and Vivian Nguyen.
Good evening, friends and family, teachers and administrators, and of course, Royal Bay Secondary's Class of 2020. My name is Vivian Nguyen.
What a do, baby, it's Momo.
And we are honored to be chosen as this year's valedictorians for the Class of 2020.
Well, boys, you picked the right flavors. So, hey, beautiful people, families, boys and girls, teachers, and most importantly, the grad class of 2020. I want you to smile right now. If you got someone beside you, look them deep in the eyes and you smile, especially if it's a parent or a friend. Because, well, grads, we made it. We started from the bottom and now the whole team is here. Bro, we survived construction at Royal Bay for 2 solid years. We'd be doing tests or talking, and all we would hear was thrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr
a biology test, and we were trying to cheat off each other. And every time the drill would hit, we'd be cheating with answers. It'd be, what you get for A, babe? Anyway, the vibration was insane at some times that the tables and the chairs would be hitting the Dougie. It was insane. What I'm trying to say, guys, is if we survive that, we can survive anything. This pandemic ain't got nothing on us.
Wherever each of us may be, we are still able to celebrate our finish of 4 joyful, chaotic, and stressful years in high school. These years may have felt long and difficult as the days inch forward. However, today, we see how quickly the most important day of our academic lives has crept up on us.
Boys and girls, the class of 2020 may be the first grad class to ever experience a pandemic in our last year. We probably are. But I'd like to say, when it comes to hard times, the grad class of 2020 pitches in to help our beautiful community and its people. For instance, our seniors this year have decided to donate half of our gotcha winnings to our local food banks to support the people that in need most in this crisis.
Evidently, in this unideal situation, this grad class has had a lot taken away from us. Our slightly terrifying game of gotcha was cut short. We couldn't wear our ridiculously expensive dresses on prom night. And most importantly, we couldn't walk across the graduation stage together with a cap on our heads, celebrating a great milestone in our life that we've all worked so hard to achieve. Yet, under current circumstances, the class of 2020 should still be able to honor our accomplishments and cherish the unforgettable memories we've created within the walls of Royal Bay. Our senior year of high school ended on a random Friday. At 2:12 p.m., we rushed out of class without a second glance. Little did we know we wouldn't be returning to finish what we've been told is the best year of high school. But instead of dwelling on what we couldn't have, we can reflect on many moments from our senior year this grad class will miss.
Like, y'all remember when Jaden and Jordan done flipped their car upside down, then they'd be posting on the gram how life is sacred and amazing? If they survive that, they can survive any pandemic. Like, they be the experts of surviving pandemics. That's all I'm saying. Take notes from the masters, fellas. I'm joking, by the way. That was a very scary day, and I'm really happy that both of y'all got out of it okay. Except for the car. That car is clapped. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is that we have overcome a lot worse things in the grad class than a dumb, dumb, ugly pandemic. I can't cuss, so I have to use that. Anyway, if 6ix9ine got out of jail during all this and is making fire music that I clap in my car, well, guys, we can just about overcome anything. Beautiful people, we are the Royal Bay grads of 2020.
Remember when our biggest concern was our grad color? Red or pink? That started a lot of arguments. Or the walks we take during a boring class to bother Mr. Burgess. Remember the 8 a.m. grad council meetings with heated discussions about the play dolls for the senior prank? Or Bryn accusing everyone of having her name for gotcha? No, Bryn, I didn't have you. Remember the herd of grade nines vaping in the bathroom every time we had to pee? Or the chaotic jungle in the cafeteria that almost left me in tears every time I tried to buy a cookie? How Deming's classes always ended up with a student being tackled in a Shakespeare play. Kevin, are you good? Or how we all happened to be part of Rose's pretty class. Was anyone ever the smart class? There were the three flights of stairs that seemed to trigger my asthma every time. And let's be honest, they probably kept us decently fit. We'll definitely miss being in Mrs. Pushka's class, where Mo was usually singing Take Me Home Country Roads at the top of his lungs.
And of course, we'll remember the top-notch country singer that was at that one assembly who had his 15 minutes of fame with Taylor Swift. Now, some of us might not know what I'm talking about, and that is totally fine. Most of us would be in the parking lot planning our escape from that assembly and dodging the admin while we do it. Mr. Bobbitt, Huck, and Johnson, we know we were a pain, but hey, you guys tried. Y'all remember when our biggest worry was having two separate grad ceremonies? Well, baby, that's not a worry no more because we got an online one. By the way, does anyone actually know what a capstone project is? Because they're apparently due soon, and I don't know what they are.
When Mo and I were writing the speech, we took a career aptitude test just out of curiosity. My results suggested careers as a casino cashier, an insurance clerk, and a driving instructor.
For myself, I got a travel agent, a wind turbine fixer, and also a driving instructor. Ironically, we both failed our driving test twice, so I don't know how good we would be at that. Probably not good.
But in the end, a computer test doesn't define the rest of our life, even if our wildest dream is to become a casino cashier.
We might not know what we want to do right now, and that is totally okay.
Right now, we have time to be young.
Right now, we have the world in front of our beautiful fingertips.
And we can plan for what's next. Though instead, right now, let us appreciate what we've already done. Today, we become high school graduates. Today, we celebrate who we've become over the past 4 years. Today, our world grows just a little bit bigger.
I'm incredibly proud to have witnessed all y'all make the first steps in achieving your dreams that you've spent years striving for.
Nothing would have been possible without the continued support from our families, teachers, coaches, and friends. To our parents and parental figures, thank you for encouraging us through the tough times, celebrating our big wins, and loving us unconditionally through it all. Thank you to the Royal Bay staff for taking us in 4 years ago and never giving up on us. You've all shaped us into who we are today. Finally, to the students of Royal Bay, thank you for being the pure heart of this school and never making a moment of our time dull.
On the real though, this class is the most resilient class that has ever attended Royal Bay. We survived portable fights of helmets and gloves. Panda for sure dropped Jet, and Brayden for sure let Obi have the first shot. We survived Ms. Beetle and the other principals that all have the same haircut, or lack of. Yeah, it's all right guys, you'll grow some, I believe in you. Now we are faced with a new challenge of surviving and enduring COVID-19. In the wise words of Drake, I'm upset. This year, we even survived the loss of the funniest, most positive, and dearest friend, Brayden. Brayden, those Borkus videos keep coming up in my Snapchat, man, and you keep making me laugh to this day. But really, Brayden, you are missed by many of us, and you will always be our ray of sunshine. With all these hardships, I believe this class can only come out of this year stronger. I can't wait to see what kind of people we become in the next coming years.
We will never again have to purposely arrive to school late to snag a parking spot in the front. Sorry, Mr. Huck.
Nor will we ever say to our teachers, see you next year.
This is it.
But with all we're saying goodbye to, there are so many new things awaiting us on our next adventure.
Wherever we may be and whatever we may be doing, it's the start of our life outside of these halls. Ready or not, world, here we come. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Royal Bay's graduating class of 2020.
Momo
and Viv.
Ow.
Laith Abu Hassan. Jackson Ackerman. Zoe Agis.
Denerika Anthonison. Nicholas Arnold.
Khan Azankara. Semi Azankara. Tessa Atherton. Ryan Baird.
Brian Bell. Wesley Bell. Dominic Belligente. Nassim Benjlil. Zeke Berg.
Cassidy Bone. Ethan Boone. Autumn Brown.
Emma Campbell. Hayden Cardinal. Cody Carter. Connor Cartmill Jones. Eric Sesford. Dawson Charles.
Colby Condon. Cameron Coney.
Ella Cottingham. Rowan Crocker. Adam Cupido.
Ethan DiMedeiros. Graham DaCosta. Sean Dennison. Jordan DeTargene. Tao Ni Diep.
Jan Dominic Fabregar. Kendall Ferguson. John Fizard.
Simone Gittens.
Gokbekagokich. Dominic Gok. Wilder Goulding.
Keisha Hookshermeyer. Braden Hutchison. Jillian Jane. Pierce Jansen. Rohith Shivaji Jethan. Christopher Jennings.
Matthew Johnson. McCallum Johnson. Jordan Johnson Vernon. Darius Jones. Khalil Jones. Nahoa Kahakawila. Matthew Kelly. Shungo Kishi. Anna Kropp. Calum LaChance.
Jericho Langewin. Sebastian Larson Lopez. Noah Lassner.
Silas Leonard. Spencer Lilliston.
Cole Mahovlich. Alexa Marginson.
Chase MacArthur. Isabel McQuaig. Piper Jane McDowell. Mullen McPeak.
Ava Morrison. Danica Nielsen.
Michaela Nolan. Jacob Obi Cooper. Pablo Ortego Maya. Jenna Oshiro. Junyan Pang.
Kaya Pratt.
Caetano Ralph. Ardi Balikwi Ramadani. Caleb Riak.
Jezreel John Rubio.
Spencer Sim.
Blake Stolf. Sawyer Storms.
Taya Tatman Zochinski.
Annalise Tiemens. Damian Vanderhorst.
Brianna Van Wiltenberg. Sydney Vogelaar. Tyler Volk. Hayden Weaver.
Aiden Woods. McKenna Rock.
Noah Soberg.
Noah's grade 12 year was like a roller coaster that never ended, filled with fun and joy, but also some bumps in the tracks. When Noah was having a rough day, he had his amazing supportive friends behind him at all times. Family is the most important and precious thing to him. He owes it all to his brother, Josh, sister Emma, and his dad for getting him to where he is now. Don't worry, he would never forget the woman that brought him into this world, his best friend, his mom, the bravest person he knows. She is the one that made him who he is today. Thank you to all teachers and staff who helped him through his schooling. Oh, and yes, he is indeed the last Soberg.
Joseph Mitchell.
Joey barely showed up, but he got the job done.
Brendan Ball.
Simone Belton.
Brendan Blythe.
Natalia Fratzik. William Galagos Condors. Aiden Morley.
Patricia Marie Ng.
Jeremy Stones.
Jesse Van Veen.
Riley Wilson. Josie Young.
I would like to thank everyone who supported the graduating class of 2020 as the ceremony draws to a close.
However, everything that has been said or done so far through the ceremony has been leading to this moment. So ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of Royal Bay Secondary School 2020.
Let's hear it for the grads of 2020!
We need the best and brightest of your generation to lead in government and in business, in the science and in the art, in journalism and in academia. There's honor in all of these pursuits, and there's opportunity to do work that's infused with moral purpose. You don't have to choose between doing good and doing well. Your challenge is to find work that pays the rent, puts food on the table, and lets you do what is right and good and just.